Hello students, welcome to this session of Engineering Graphics and Design. Myself, Vimal Salot from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. In this session, we are going to discuss about different types of lines and methods of dimensioning. Drawing is defined as an art of representation of the object with systematic lines. So here, whatever lines are used, they have different meanings. So each and every line has different format and it has some particular meaning. Now let's see what are the different types of lines. First type of line is continuous thick. It is used to show visible outlines or visible edges of the object. Next type of line is continuous thin. It is used to draw dimension line, extension line, leader line, hatchings, etc. As compared to continuous thick line, this type of line is thinner or lighter. Next type of line is continuous thin wavy line. This type of line is used to indicate irregular boundaries of the object or to show the short break. Then next type of line is continuous thin with zigzag. It indicates long break, or it is used to show the cut part of non-uniform cross section. Next type of line is dotted line. It may be dashed thick or it may be dashed thin, but it is used to show invisible details or hidden details of the object. Then chain thin, its format is long dash, short dash, alternate form. This type of line is used to show the axis of symmetry or to draw the center line or trajectories of the object. Then this type of line, you can see here, it has some difference with this long chain thin line. Its format is long chain thin, but it is thick at ends but thin elsewhere, and it is used to indicate the position of the cutting plane. Then chain thick line, here you can see it is somewhat thick or dark. It indicates the surface to which some special treatment is to be given. For example, if any surface is to be given heat treatment, then this type of line is used in drawing. Then chain thin double dashed line, here long dashed, then you can see there are double dashed. So this type of line is used to show the alternative positions of the movable component. Now let's see example and where this type of lines are used. So here two views of the object are shown. In this view, you can see it is the boundary line or the outline of the view. And here in this view, it is the boundary line or outline of the view. To draw the boundary line or outline, continuous thick type of line is used. So it is a type of line. Then here some dimensions are written. The line which is used to show the dimension is known as the dimension line, and the limits of the dimension are shown by the extension line. So here it is extension line, it is also extension line. So all the dimensions are written with extension line and with dimension line. Dimension line is terminated with two arrowheads at the ends. The format of line used is continuous thin. Here you can see this type of lines are known as hatchings or the section line. It indicates the cut surface of the object. Here also the format used is continuous thin. Here you can see it is a circular hole, and the diameter is written outside of this hole as there is no sufficient space here to write down the dimension. If it happens, then this type of line is used to write down the dimension outside the particular feature, and this format is known as the leader line, and its format is continuous thin line. Here you can see it is dotted line, it is also dotted line. So this particular hole is visible in one view, but it is invisible in another view. So here dotted lines are used to indicate the invisible details. Format is short dashed line. This line indicates the center line of the object. Here also it indicates the center line. So format used is long chain thin. Its format is long dash and short dash are in alternate form. This line is known as the CPL, cutting plane line. Its format is long chain thin elsewhere, but thick at ends with two capital letters and arrowhead. So it is a cutting plane line. It is a movable component, and the position, the alternative position of this component is shown by this dotted line. So here you can see locus line is used. It shows the path where it is moving on this path. So its format is long dash, then double dash format is used. Then here you can see it is continuous thin wavy line, and it is used to indicate irregular boundaries or uniform cross section. Of the format is continuous thin with zigzag. It is used to indicate long break, or it is used to indicate the cut section of non-uniform cross section part. Now, next topic is methods of dimensioning. There are two methods which are used to write down the dimensions of any view. They are known as align method and unidirectional method. Here, one view of the object is shown with similar dimensions. All the dimensions and details are similar, but the method by which all the dimensions are written is different. Let's see what is the difference between these two methods. Here you can see it is horizontal dimension. These all are horizontal dimensions, but all the horizontal dimensions are readable from the bottom side of the drawing. It is vertical dimension, it is vertical dimension. So all these vertical dimensions are readable from the right hand side of the drawing. Next point is, all the dimension lines are continuous lines. They are not break from anywhere, and the dimension digit is inserted almost on the middle part of the dimension line. In case of unidirectional method, horizontal dimensions, here you can see these are the horizontal dimensions and these are the vertical dimensions. All the dimensions, horizontal and vertical as well, all the dimensions are readable from the bottom side of the drawing. So we can say all the dimensions are readable from one direction, and that's why it is known as the unidirectional method of dimensioning. All the dimension lines are break in between almost from the middle part of the dimension line, and dimension digit is inserted there. So these are the main differences between align method and unidirectional method of dimensioning. Thank you very much for watching.